Hello friends, welcome to my channel Learning English with Bhashwati Teacher. I am going to teach you higher level English of Maharashtra State Board Curriculum 10th Standard Lesson Number 1.1 Where the Mind is Without Fear. I am Mrs. Bhashwati Banerjee who has created this video. Message to my dear viewers. Dear viewers, I have created this channel to help the students of Maharashtra State Board who are going to appear for the SSC examination. I have tried to make the explanation of this lesson interesting by adding few more pieces of extra information. I want my viewers to understand the underlying concept or principle better and help to enable them put their ideas in better words. Enjoy the poem. Regards, Bhashwati Banerjee. Some additional information. Rabindranath Tagore was born as Rabindranath Thakur. He was also known by his sobriquets Gurudev, Kabi Guru and Vishwakavi. He was a Bengali polymath. What is polymath? Polymath is a person of great and varied learning. He was poet, musician and artist. He reshaped Bengali literature and music. He is sometimes referred to as the Bard of Bengal. Bard is a storyteller. Songs of Rabindranath Tagore are called as Rabindra Sangeet. Tagore was a prolific composer of songs. His songs are known as Rabindra Sangeet, which means fluidity, which merges fluidity into his literature. It is influenced by the Thumri style of Hindustani music. Now these are the collection of photographs of Rabindranath Tagore, and here two good thoughts are there. Like, these two are my favorite thoughts. The highest education is that which does not merely give us information but makes our life in harmony with all existence. And next thought is, you can't cross the sea merely by standing and staring at the water. That is, you have to get up and start working if you want to achieve something in life. So these are the collections of photographs of Rabindranath Tagore. Then another collection of photographs shows that Shantiniketan University, this was actually set up by Rabindranath Tagore. Another photo shows Rabindranath Tagore hosting Gandhiji and his wife Kasturba Gandhi. In another photo, we can see Rabindranath Tagore interacting with Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Here we can see Albert Einstein with Rabindranath Tagore. Gitanjali is the collection of poems, and this is the cover page of the book. Here this is Rabindranath Tagore in Germany 1931. And we can see here a young Rabindranath Tagore with his wife Mrinalini Devi. The initial information which is given in the textbook is, when the poem starts, where the mind is without fear. Rabindranath Tagore, 1861 to 1941. He was the author of Gitanjali and his profoundly sensitive, fresh and beautiful verse. He became the first non-European to win the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1913. This poem is of his vastly read and discussed poem. It was originally composed in Bengali and later he himself translated into English. This poem is from his Nobel Prize winning anthology Gitanjali. Tagore lived during the time when India was ruled by the British. In this poem, besides political freedom from British, Tagore also appeals to God for social, educational and economic freedom for the people of India. Let us start with the poem. First, I will read the poem for you and then I will explain you the poem line by line. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out of from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way, into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee, into ever widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. And here, before I explain the poem to you, let us go through the word meanings. Narrow domestic walls, it means division on the basis of religion, caste, class and color in societies between countries of the world. Tireless striving, it means continuous efforts and struggle. Stretches its arms, it means aims at achieving a goal. Dead habit, it means old traditional rituals and customs that are harmful, ever widening, forever broadening and one's outlook, and heaven of freedom, condition of total freedom of good thoughts, good words and good deeds while respecting those of others. Now come, let's go back to our poem and I will start the line by line explanation. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Here the poet dreams of a world, dreams of a country where everyone is fearless. Fearless in the sense, fearlessness from despotism, fearlessness from tyranny. And he, where everyone can lead a life of dignity with his head held high. Where knowledge is free. Where knowledge is free in the sense you have freedom of everything, where everyone is knowledgeable, where everyone has the right to gain knowledge, where there is no discrimination. Where the world has not been broken up into fragments. I mean, there are no factions, there are no cults, and there are no differences, groups of people, just by the narrow domestic walls on the basis of religion or color or caste or creed. The world is not divided. I mean, the country or the people are not divided. There is unity among diversity of the people. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where truth is prevalent, where there is no corruption prevalent, wherever there is truth, there only the growth of the country can take place. So where words come from the depth of truth, where there is no lie, liars do not exist, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. Tireless striving is to work hard constantly, incessantly, relentlessly. Striving is to work hard. Tirelessly, that is without getting tired. Stretches its arms towards perfection. That means where people are hard worker and where people are always endeavoring to become better and better. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way. I mean, everything is reason. There is a reason behind everything. Nothing is unreasonable in the society which was imagined by Rabindranath Tagore. Into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Dreary is a place which is very gloomy, which is very dull, where there is no enthusiasm. So imagine one desert where there is only sand, and this sand is of dead habit. Here you can see the meaning of dead habit is given. It is old traditional rituals and customs that are harmful. So old dreary, if your world where there are old rituals like sati pratha or other superstitions are prevalent, then such a land will become a dreary desert. That is a gloomy desert. Where the mind is led forward by thee. Here why the T is capital? Because it refers to God. So the poet wants that our mind should be shown the correct direction by God himself. Into ever widening thought and action. That is, ever widening means our outlook should be broad. So our thoughts and our action should be very broad, not narrow. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. And the heaven of freedom is an imaginary place. You can also call it as utopia. Heaven of freedom is a place where people have equal rights to live, to express their thoughts, where there is mutual coexistence, where we give respect, where we take respect. My father, father again, F is capital, that means it is again God. Let my country awake. So these were the words of Rabindranath Tagore. Appreciation of the poem. There is, let us talk about the rhyme scheme. It is a free verse which makes the poem one big complex sentence. I mean, there is no specific rhyme scheme here. Favorite line, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. This line makes the whole poem a prayer. It's an appeal made to God. Student can write any of their favorite lines. Central idea of the poem is the poet's desire to see his countrymen free and the qualities he wishes to see in them, as well as hopes for a better future. Then figures of speech. Figures of speech add to the beauty of the poem. Tagore has used apostrophe, metaphor, alliteration, synecdoche and personification to express his thoughts. Let us talk about the special features of the poem. The poem is a prayer poem written in a serious tone that echoes patriotism throughout. The mood transcends from gloomy in the beginning to hopeful in the last two sentences. The use of into in the last two sentences not only ushers in hope but also lends a sense of clarity. Underlining the theme of the poem, the implied meaning that the poet wishes to convey is that only when people experience freedom of mind and spirit can a country progress. Through the beautiful use of imagery such as clear stream of reason and dreary sand of dead habit, the poet represents his vision for a brighter tomorrow for India, while he indirectly acknowledges the reality of the present.